I am pleased, desperately pleased, to announce that the PDF of Strongholds and Followers is now available. If you backed or pre-ordered and your order included the PDF and you don't have any balance due, you should by now have gotten the link to download the PDF. If you have any questions or complaints about the rules or the text or the content of the book, please come by our subreddit or our Discord. There will be links in the doobly-doo. The subreddit and the Discord are the best places for any questions or comments about the content of the book. If you're having problems getting the book, if you have questions about your account or downloading, you can email hello@mcdmproductions.com. Please be patient. We are already getting a ton of emails. Anna has made a video I will link to below that walks you through the entire process of logging into our online shop and getting your book. This is for backers and pre-orders who have paid their balance. If you're just buying the PDF now, it should be pretty straightforward. Please do not email me rules, questions, or complaints. I never check my email. Please do not direct message me. Same thing. If you ask me questions in the YouTube comments or on Twitter, there's a good chance I won't see them. The subreddit and the Discord are best because when one person asks a question, everyone can see the response, and they're both easy to search, and the subreddit is threaded discussion, so it's organized, and I am there, and I respond to folks regularly. The physical book won't be ready until next year. I'm guessing late Q1, early Q2. It takes time to print and ship everything, and there's still a couple of layout things to be done that are unique to the print product. The minis are being manufactured. We plan on doing a whole video with Dave from Trenchworks. Either we're gonna fly up there or they'll come down here showing how it's done. The shirts and stickers have started arriving at the shipping warehouses, so everything is happening. So all the physical stuff is in process, and the last piece of that is actually printing the book. Now the process of digesting the content begins. This is a big book. It's over 250 pages packed with rules and systems and new monsters and items, and there is a lot to talk about, and I have no idea what people will think. I mean, I guess I know that some folks will like some bits and some folks really will not like other bits. And folks in our community will probably look more favorably on it than the rest of the buying public. The story of the Kickstarter so far has been about how much money we raised. And of course it is. We raised a colossal amount of money. But to me, success or failure is based on the product, two products, the stream and the book, and this is the book. So to me, we're only successful if people like the book, if people use it, I should say. I judge the book successful if folks take it and use it in their games and it becomes part of the culture of the game. If people read it and like it, that makes me happy. But if I see folks using it, folks outside the MCDM community, then I will think we succeeded. Because we want the book to be used, we're gonna be continually updating it based on feedback as long as is practical. Obviously, not all feedback turns into a revision. We're gonna be doing a lot of listening and then a lot of talking and maybe some testing and then revise the book. I don't know what the schedule for that is going to be. Whenever we reprint the book, it will have the most current version of the text. I think the best products, this is something I learned in video games, I think the best products respond to the way people use them and are therefore constantly revised. So if, for instance, folks end up using retainers in a way I had never considered, we will revise those rules to support that. Until today, the book was mine. Now it's yours, and how you use it will inform where we go with it. The rules in this book are my own personal vision for how these things should work, and they're not presented as anything else. They have my ideas baked into them, they use my language, and you will see what I mean. The book reads like a giant YouTube video, and for some people that'll make it easy and fun to read, and for other people it will be the opposite. But there is one section I consider a more general purpose solution. Warfare, battles between large armies, has never been part of the core rules, but I think it's something the game needs, and even more than rules for strongholds and followers, we will all benefit if there are good rules for warfare. To that end, we are opening the entire section on warfare, all the rules and how to build units. If all we cared about was generating revenue, we would want you to have to come to us for more units and traits and stuff. But my hope is that we collectively produce a set of warfare rules that people like and will use outside the context of this book, or me, or this company. Opening the warfare rules means Anyone who wants to can use them in their homebrew stuff or their official published stuff. Anyone, any company, can take these warfare rules and reprint them, modify them, create their own scenarios, their own units. Only the warfare rules are open, by the way, not the entire book. We're opening the warfare rules because we hope it will increase the odds that these rules become sort of the default solution for giant battles, and I think this is the best way to get there. Let anyone take them and rewrite them and mod them, and the best solutions will rise to the top. At least that's the idea. We'll see. Our next book is Kingdoms and Warfare, which expands on the rules in this book and lets you run an organization, a barony, or a wizard college, or a thieves guild, and gives those organizations new, unique things to do. And it will have an expanded version of the warfare rules in this book. We're not gonna launch that Kickstarter until everything from this Kickstarter has shipped and people have had a chance to react to it. That means the physical book and the minis, everything. I don't want to go into the second product until you have had a chance to react to the first one and therefore have some idea what you're going to get in the next one. If you want to be notified when that Kickstarter goes live, there's a form you can fill out in the doobly-doo. We will only use your email to alert you to the launch of the next Kickstarter. Now, we have a really good, actually a quite amazing, I think, community. This community is positive and inclusive and supportive, so if you have questions, you will get answers pretty quickly. But that positivity has a flip side, which I would like to address. Dear community members, you are going to see a lot of folks in the days and weeks to come show up in these places that you consider yours and be critical of the book. Some of them are going to be very critical. Please do not dogpile on these people. If someone needs to vent about something, let them. Just let them say their piece. That's probably all they want. I've already seen folks say, I don't like the whatever, and other people jump on them. It is okay not to like things. Let people not like stuff. If folks are going out of their way to be wang rods, we will take care of it. I think we're going to see a lot of moderation in the next couple of weeks. There are always people who have a negative reaction to a product and they feel like this is incredibly important and something must be done. But these folks are rare, and in those instances where we feel the book would be improved by making a change, we will make that change. A lot of people worked on this book. A lot of people. If you like the book, it's because of all those people working hard. It's because of artists and graphic designers and writers and designers and playtesters. If you don't like the book, if there's a rule or a system or a paragraph or a smiley face you don't like, that is 100% on me. Everything in this book reflects my design, my style, my aesthetic, even the things that don't, and there are some, I was still the final word on that decision, and I stand by it. The next book will be better. Production will be smoother. But I am responsible for every decision made in the book. If you're going to be upset about something, be upset at me. That's it, folks. I hope you enjoy the book. I hope it's fun to read, and I hope some of it makes it into your game. If you do cool stuff with the book, please let us know. Twitter is great for that stuff. I hope this is just the beginning, and we get to do a lot more stuff like this. We have learned so much. I am desperate to put that knowledge to use in the next book. What was the point in learning all this, sometimes painfully, if not to do better next time? I wanted to continue the world-building stream this Saturday, but I think it's probably folly to release a book like this and then jump on Twitch and try to talk about anything else. So this Saturday, we'll be live on Twitch at 11 a.m. Pacific time, talking about the book. Maybe we'll play some NetHack if the book discussion dies down or gets repetitive. I'll be happy to explain my thinking and my process and hear your reactions to everything, but this stream is not going to be the stream where I rewrite the rules because people are complaining. The process of revision will take a while. It involves more testing. It won't happen on the spur of the moment in a stream, but I think there will be a lot to talk about. Then, the Saturday after that, back to world building, and soon, pretty soon, I hope, we will launch the D&D stream. Until then, until next time, peace out. Speaking of our amazing, while I have you all here, speaking of our amazing community, we got a very nice letter from one of our community leaders. It's Atrap, whom some of you may know from our Twitch streams. If you log into the Twitch stream and you see that you've got a little subscriber icon next to your name, but you don't remember subscribing, there's a good chance it's because It's Atrap sent you a gift subscription on Twitch. We actually have a lot of people who have gifted subscriptions to folks, but It's Atrap has donated quite a few, and It's Atrap chap sent us, he 3D modeled and then 3D printed and then 3D painted his own version. Very, very close. As far as I can tell, it's perfectly accurate to the art. This is one of the creatures that you can summon from Strongholds and Followers. This is a throne. I remember the name of it because he put it on a throne. It comes out of the throne. And this is one of the celestial hosts that will come and fight with you if you build a temple and you use your concordance. And I think it looks amazing. He did this all on his own. And in addition to sending us this, he sent us a box, which he 3D modeled and 3D printed and then painted himself. It's got our logo all over it. And inside the box is an unpainted, unassembled version of the same thing. So if we want to, we can get it pro-painted. But I don't know why we would do that, because this version is remarkable. We're incredibly lucky to have folks like It's a Trap in our community. He mentions in his letter that it was the solo session we did with Gertz, just me playing with my friend Gertz, getting him onboarded into the campaign, that flipped the switch and made him understand how to DM. We should probably do a video on solo sessions. People ask about that a lot. Maybe I could even run another one and do some more. Now that we have a solo session with Gertz was the very first thing we ever streamed. We've gotten much better at it. We've gotten a little better at it. And so I think it would be neat to do another one of those. So thanks again, It's a Trap, for the support. Thanks for the very cool gifts. Thanks for gifting the Twitch subs to folks. It is my sincere hope that we just get to keep doing this, that we just get to keep making cool stuff for you folks, and that it finds an audience and that the audience engages with it. We're incredibly lucky to have this community. There is one more thing I want to add. MCDM Productions is not just me. I could not have gotten here. I could not have gotten across the finish line. I could not be making this video in this space if it wasn't for the work of Jerry, if it wasn't for the work of Anna and Lars. People put in a colossal amount of work to get here, including stuff like building this set and getting this technology and figuring out how to stream things to you, figuring out how to record this video, figuring out how to do the layout, art direction, contacting artists, the playtest, running the playtest and coordinating all that stuff, communicating with people. It is a colossal amount of work, and it is my sincere hope that those of you who backed the Kickstarter, those of you who pre-ordered the book since then, those of you who come onto Twitch and supported this by subscribing as a Twitch supporter, I hope that you see where your money's going. I am incredibly proud of this book. I think it's beautiful. I think that you can see where the money goes. And part of that is having a company and a team that can produce a really high quality product. So thanks, my thanks to Jerry, Anna, and Lars. And hopefully, we're getting pretty close to the end of 2018. Hopefully 2019 is even better. Hopefully we get to keep doing this for a long time. So that's the real end of the video, folks. Until next time, peace.